Proverbs 2:7. Vitzpon la yesharim tushia, magain leholeche tom. So we've got some things to talk about here in chapter 2, verse 7. Let's begin with just kind of a bit of a translation and get it under our belt, and then we'll come back and talk about especially this form. I've got the note from the BHS critical apparatus down here. I also want to talk about this word, teshuyah. Teshuyah, there it is. And then we want to talk about the concept of a shield, that sort of thing. So a few fascinating things here. We get, and he stores up for, this I think is a lamed of advantage, for the upright. Notice you might see the yashar there, that root having to do with straight or right. He stores up for the upright. And then here we get the word sound wisdom. We'll come back to that here in just a minute, or sound judgment. And then we have a shield, and we might could add here maybe something like he is, with this third masculine singular verb up here. We could say that he is in parallelism. He is a shield to the ones who walk. And then we get tom, and this is a nominal form meaning complete or total, but it has to do here with totality of integrity, complete integrity. Or we might see something like who walks in uprightness or integrity. So let's look at a few of these pieces. Let's start with the verb form right here and take a look at it. Now, it does look a little bit bizarre here. If you look at the BHS apparatus, you'll see that this actually is a kativ kare. And so the kativ, many of you know, is what is written. You might think of the verb katav, written. And then the kare is what is to be read. Now, both of these are forms that from the Aramaic, kativ kare, what is to be written, and or what is written versus what is to be read. And this is just really the way that the Masoretes helped us out, or tried to help us out with saying. This is a little bit of an odd form in the consonantal text, but we want to try to help you out and show you what this ought to look at. It's interpretive. You can take it or leave it. You can, you know, research, do some deep dive, and decide what you think is best as far as understanding this. But I don't take the proposal here of BHS, but that's another story. So anyway, let's look at the kativ kare here. Notice in the kativ, you'll see that the Greek, the Septuagint, and the Syriac both follow this reading, vetzafan. And so this would be something like, and as a vav consecutive, and he shall store up for the upright sound judgment. The kare, what is to be read, is followed by the targums and the Vulgate. So the thing that's interesting here is you've got attestation in all of these cases for a decent reading. So, and he shall store up. And then if you notice the kare, again, targum here and the Vulgate, it's being read as an imperfect or some sort of continuous action aspect. He stores up. Again, notice third masculine singular here with that yod performative. He stores up for the upright sound judgment. And so maybe a little bit of help there navigating that kativ kare. Here, what happens with a kativ kare is what is written stays. So notice that vav at the beginning stays. The Masoretes don't change that, but they give it the vowel points of what they say ought to be read. And so you'll look at a consonantal text with a vav in this case, but they show you in the margin it should be read with a yod and then the vowel pointing that you see here in the form. So it's a little difficult to do with digital copies because you kind of see the form here, and I don't copy over the little marker right here that would tell you to go look at the note. So you may or may not catch it. So since we have time today, wanted to show you that one. So I would take this with the kare here, and he stores up for the upright sound judgment. Let's talk about that just for a moment. This is one of many words in the book of Proverbs that refers to wisdom or knowledge. or what is good and right to think about and how to live. But this particular word, I'm looking at some notes here that I have from Andrew Steinman's commentary. He's got a great commentary with these words and kind of explains them. He says that this is the faculty to evaluate and make judgments on the best course of actions in life. And it's not just the ability to discern that or evaluate it, but then actually to carry it out and live that way. And so you can see here kind of in the connotations of tushia, you can see this idea of living uprightly. So the Lord gives to the upright this discerning ability to think through the correct path of life, the best path of life. And so maybe that's from experience. Wisdom is experiential in that sense. You do something, you learn from it, and then you know now to do it again because you have discerned through living uprightly that that's the best way to do it. And the Lord stores this up for the upright. So just a rich verse there. And then we get the parallelism here. So he stores up for the upright sound judgment. He is a shield. Think here now, protection, right? Think protection. He is a shield to the ones who walk uprightly or with integrity, we might say. The verb here, we'll just cover this, is a call participle. The verbal root is he, lamed, kaf. And then notice we get this, it's a construct participle, masculine plural. So the ones who walk with integrity, tom. And so not only does the Lord store up this this sound judgment for those who live rightly, but that sound judgment also is a shield. It protects you. So it's like, okay, I've lived this way. I've lived this way wisely and in the fear of the Lord, and the Lord has given me the ability to discern then how to continue doing that, and that is going to be the very thing that shields me from folly. And so just, again, I could go on and on about these verses, I think, rich verses to just unpeel and unpack them for all that they're worth. But we've got the Kativ Kare here on that one, a rich word here with tushia, and then we've got this guarding shield that the Lord gives to us as we walk with integrity.